Mr. Speaker, today I rise in opposition to House Resolution 836. The governor's emergency declaration effective March 6, 2020 was critical and needed so our state could be repositioned to direct all resources and personnel as deemed necessary to cope with the emergency situation of this novel coronavirus. While it's easy to look back with a critical lens and analyze all the steps taken by the administration under the powers of that order, we can't argue that this pandemic isn't real. While it is easy to look backward with a critical lens and analyze all the steps taken by the administration under the powers of this order, we can't argue that this pandemic isn't real, that the virus isn't novel, meaning new and without any previous data, and that our response hasn't evolved as the data and science warranted. Mr. Speaker, there is no doubt that the COVID-19 pandemic has placed extreme personal, financial, and emotional burdens on our families, our communities, and our small businesses. But H.R. 836 will only further the burden and hardship because, as illustrated, it is real. And thanks to losing my trust in thinking that all of my colleagues have all of our health and safety today, I went and got tested because I can't trust what some of the people decide for all of us and all of the employees and their families. This virus will not magically go away. Again, Mr. Speaker, a virus that quietly lurked among us in the chamber to no longer be a danger to the people we represent. Mr. Speaker, while I'm sure there are many of us who haven't agreed with the way the administration has communicated with this body, that does not mean we need this resolution. Now is not the time for political theater. If that were the case, we would all be wearing masks, wouldn't we? Mr. Speaker, I'll be voting no on this resolution, and I encourage you to do also. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.